Chapter number 10, Operations Research. Exercise 10.1. Question number 1. What is the transportation problem? So the meaning of transportation problem is, we have taken the goods from one place to another is known as a transportation problem. And then the cost is minimized. So the transportation problem is to determine the amount to be transported from each origin to each destination such that the total transportation cost is minimized. Question number 2. Write mathematical form of transportation problem. So the mathematical formulation of a transportation problem can be taken as, first we have to put objective function, second one is subject to the constraint, the third one is a non-negativity restrictions. So the first one in the is minimize, so the cost will be, so the transportation problem, the cost will be minimized. Z equal to sigma I equal to 1TM, J equal to 1TN, CAJ, XAJ. So this is the short form of the objective function. Suppose you have to put I equal to 1, J equal to 1, C 1 1. Again, I equal to 1, J equal to 1, C 1 1, X 1 1. Again, C 1 2, X 1 2. Keep on going on. So J equal to 1, I equal to 1, and J equal to 1. So the expansion is keep on going on. This is the short form, mathematical form. Subject to the constraints, sigma J equal to 1 to N, Xij equal to Ai, I equal to 1 to M, supply constraint. First we have to put the supply constraint, next one is a demand constraint. Suppose the problem, given problem is given in, demand is given in row is means, supplies are given in column is. Suppose supply is given in column is means demand is given in row is. So sigma I equal to 1 to M, Xij equal to Bj, J equal to 1 to N, demand constraint. Finally, we have to put the non-negativity restrictions, Xij is greater than or equal to 0. So this is the mathematical formulation of a transportation problem. Question number 3. What is the feasible solution and non-degenerate solution in transportation problem? So the feasible solution for the problem can be all set of all non-negative values, Xij, all Xijs are greater than or equal to 0. It's non-negativity values. Non-negativity values means all Xijs are greater than or equal to 0. I equal to 1TM, J equal to 1TM. Then satisfies the constraints if the basic feasible solution to a transportation problem contains exactly M plus N minus 1 allocations. M means number of rows, N means number of column minus 1. This is the formula for non-degenerate basic feasible solution. So it is equal to allocations in independent positions. So M plus N minus 1 equal to number of allocations or occupied cells. Both are same. Occupied cells are allocations. So M plus N minus 1 just exactly equal to the occupied cells. So this one is a balanced transportation problem. So M equal to number of rows and N equal to number of column. So this problem is a non-degenerate. So M plus N minus 1 cells, which is exactly equal to number of occupied cells. So this is known as a non-degenerate basic feasible solution. Question number 4. What do you mean by balanced transportation problem? Balanced transportation problem means the total supply is equal to total demand is known as a balanced transportation problem. And mathematically, total supply equal to total demand. So I equal sigma I equal to 1 tm, ai equal to sigma j equal to 1 tm, bj. So I equal to 1 tm means a1 plus a2 plus a3 etc. up to am. I runs over from 1 tm. Again, j runs over from 1 tm means b1 plus b2 plus b3 etc. up to bm. So total supply equal to total demand is known as a balanced transportation problem. Can see proof.